Welcome back to another video of Master IV Fluid course, and today we're gonna continue on fluid resuscitation in today in DKA and hyperosmolar hyperglycemic state. As soon as you get called to see a patient with DKA or hyperosmolar hyperglycemic state in the ED, go ahead and give 2 to 3 liters immediately of NS or lactated drinker. This is whether they are hemodynamically stable or not. You give this, patient still unstable, give another 1 to 2 liters. Remember, in pure volume depleted patients, you need to restore their volume and continue giving them volume until they are hemodynamically stable, or if they start developing pulmonary edema, that's a different scenario. That's the only limiting factors. You should only use vasopressors if they are profoundly hemodynamically unstable. This is while you infusing fluid, giving them volume. Never give vasopressors and stop giving them volume. And this is in fluid pure volume depletion, like DKA, hyperosmolar hyperglycemic state, hemorrhagic shock, non-hemorrhagic shock from severe vomiting, diarrhea, etc., even septic shock. You always need to resuscitate volume. And vasopressors comes after that. Now, once they become stable, let's say they are stable now, you check their sodium level. If they are hyponatremic, then use half an S at 250 to 500 ml per hour. And during that, keep checking their hemodynamics, heart rate, blood pressure, urine output, skin turgor. And if you feel they are adequately resuscitated, you can come down on this rate and eventually stop it, right? If they are normal, having normal sodium, use the same half an S at the same rate, whatever we talked about here. If they are hyponatremic, then it makes sense that we use normal NS or LR. I would use normal NS at the 250, 500 ml per hour, and follow these parameters. And of course, come down on this rate if the patient is adequately resuscitated. Now, in all of these cases, if the blood sugar drop equal or less than 250, some say 200, some say 300, add please D5W to whatever solution you are using, half an S, NS here, because these patients are on insulin drip, of course, and we need to avoid hypoglycemia. Now, if they are looking more stable, adequately resuscitated, you can come down on the rate to 150, to 100. I usually keep the fluids until I'm ready to switch off insulin drip and they start eating, right? The only limiting factor, of course, remember, pulmonary edema and worsening hypoxia in all these cases. Now, remember, we only talking about fluid resuscitation here, so we have not talked about management of potassium and hyperkalemia here, or when to add bicarb drip and how to titrate insulin drip. That's in a separate video for DKA. Bicarb drip, will add a video here in this course on the use of bicarb drip and how to use it and how fast. So we'll stop here. I'll see you next video. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel and activate the notification bell so you get to see the videos as soon as they are released. Glad to have you on board.